So now we will see the IoT architectural reference model. So the first major contribution of IoT architectural reference model is the IoT arm, and that is nothing but IoT reference model itself. An arm processor is one of the family of CPUs which is based on RISC. What is RISC? RISC is nothing but reduced instruction set computer, but was developed by the advanced RISC machines, and the ARM processors are extremely used in consumer electronic devices such as smartphones, tablets, multimedia players. All this we have seen in embedded system. So because of their reduced instruction set, they require fewer transistors, which enables the smaller size for integrated circuit. The ARM processor smaller size, reduced complexity and lower power consumption makes it suitable for the miniaturized devices because they are very small in size. Besides models, the IoT reference model provides the concept and definitions on which the IoT architectures can be built. The primary and thus the key model is IoT domain model, which describes all the concepts that are relevant in IoT. We can see that this is the IoT domain model, where the information, IoT information model is there, which is representing the IoT system. The information is handled by the functional components. Concept of function is given, where we are having the IoT communication model, IoT trust, security and privacy model. So the IoT domain model. All other models and IoT reference architecture are based on the concepts that are introduced in IoT domain model. While certain models such as IoT communication model and IoT trust, security, privacy model might be less critical in the application scenario, the IoT domain model is mandatory for all usages of IoT ARM. The IoT reference model aims at establishing the common grounding and common languages for IoT architectures. In this generic, user needs to interact with the physical entity in the physical world. In IoT, we must or we want to be able to interact directly or mediated, that is, by calling a service that will either provide information about the physical entity or act on it. So the physical entities are represented in the digital world by the virtual entity, and this term is also called as the virtual counterpart. So we can say that the IoT context, the virtual entity has the two physical fundamental properties, that is, they are digital artifacts. So virtual entities, what do you mean by digital artifacts? So virtual entities are associated to a single physical entity, and it represents the physical entity, while there is generally only one physical entity for each universe, for each virtual entity. And it is possible that same physical entity can be associated to several virtual entities. So for example, different representation per application domain can be there. Each virtual entity must have one and only one ID that identifies it. Virtual entities are digital artifacts that can be classified either active or passive. So active digital artifacts are running software applications, and passive digital artifacts are passive software elements like database entries and all. Then the second one, that is, they are having the relevant digital parameters. So they are having the relevant digital parameters because they are representing the characteristics of physical entity, which are updated upon change of the former. In the same way, changes that affect the virtual entity should manifest themselves in the physical entity. So these are the two basic fundamental properties that are used. There are basically three types of devices for in terms or in point of view of IoT: sensors, tags and actuators. So the sensors provide information, knowledge, data about the physical entity they monitor. This ranges from identity of physical entity to measure of that physical state of entity. Then the second one is tags, which are used to identify the entities to which tags are physically attached. This identification process is called as reading. Then comes the actuators. They can modify the physical state of physical entity, like changing the state of physical entities or activating or deactivating the functionalities. So these are the basic types of devices that are needed. Then comes the services. So the resource level service exposes the functionality usually of device by accessing the hosted resources. So these kind of services generally are called as single resource. Then comes the virtual entity level services. This provides the access to information at virtual entity level. They can be services associated to single virtual entity because that gives access to attributes for reading the attribute information. Then comes the integrated service, which are the result of service composition of resource level and virtual entity level services. Then the identification of physical entities. So in order to track and monitor the physical entities, they have to be identified, and there are basically two ways for which that can be done. Then the context and location. So as the IoT pertains to the physical world, the characteristics of physical world play an important role, and all elements of physical world are situated within the certain context. So these are the services that are needed. Then the information model. So the IoT information model, which defines the structure of all the information like relation, attribute, services, and it has the attributes with name and the type. Then comes the entity model, where we can have the specification about attributes and features of real world object. Then the resource model, which contains the information that is essential to identify the resources by the unique identifier. Then the service description model. Services provide access to resources and are used to access the information to control the entities. Then the event model, that are quite essential in today's IoT architecture because they are tracking the dynamic changes in the system. So that is about the information model. Then comes the functional model. So abstract, that is nothing but the functional model is not directly tied to the technology, application domain or implementation. Then the functionality groups and interactions. So the functional model contains both functionality groups and interaction. So the list of functionality groups alone would not be enough for that. So groups and interaction both are mandatory. Functional view. It describes the system's runtime components, responsibilities and functions. Functional model diagram. So they are basically having the abstractions identified like application, virtual entity, communication, and the requirements are expressed by the stakeholders regarding the possibility to build the services. And the management transversal is required for management of interaction between the groups. So that is the functionality model. So all this is about the IoT reference model and the details. In our next section, now we will see the taxonomy. That is the taxonomy of machine learning algorithms. Thank you.